check this thing out. Oh, fuck. It's been sitting a while. Check out this diamond in the rough. Here it is, 1984 Honda 250R. I just pulled this thing out from backyard under a tree, covered in spiders. Covered in spiders. This thing's probably been sitting there for who knows how many years. Let's pull these fenders off. Fenders have a crack right there. It's got a t-shirt as a seat cover on it. Probably pull that off and see it. Let's see what the seat looks like. Oh, I can feel it's all ripped up. I'm gonna do a compression test. See if I can get this thing to fire up.
Oh my god, they have this banana peanut butter smoothie. I don't care that I'm lactose.
Alright guys, so got the fenders off, as you can know, you've already seen. I took the carb off. It's just two hose clamps right there, kinda pulls right out. I'm not gonna clean this yet. I'm almost certain that it needs a cleaning. We'll do that in a minute. But I'm gonna show you a little backyard trick. I mean, not too recommended that people do this very often, but I do it. So once the carb's off, I just wanna see if this thing will fire. Just a little splash of gas in the lid. Dump it down right in the intake and kick it over. If it's gonna fire, it'll fire and run full throttle with no carburetor on there. So just be ready to put your hand over it. Alright. Look there. Yes, check the spark plug. Oh. Check the spark plug and see if, see if that looks good. It's probably as old as the whole bike, so we'll see. It's a broken ratchet. Whoa. Okay. That right there, my friends. Massive problem. I don't think it will even fire without a carb on there with a spark plug like that. So, I'm gonna grab some sandpaper real quick. I'm gonna go get a new one later. For right now though, see if we can clean this one up. Look at that, all that black off there. It looks like it's gapped a little wrong, but slide it back in there and just for quicks and see if she'll fire. She should still have some gas in the intake. get this just hand tight for now. Pop this back on. Oh, gotta pop out the pipe there. A little more gas. Alright, so I'm gonna look on the fire from right there. I'm not sure if it's just the plug or what. Might pull the plug again real quick. See if it sparks outside, because if the plug's not sparking, it's not gonna fire. Probably should have checked that first, but whatever. Sparking pretty good. So I guess next up is a compression test. Figure out if it's got compression, so I'm gonna pull the tank off. Let's see what size of it is. Okay. That's all the compression I'm getting. So I assume top end's out. So I'm gonna pull the cylinder apart and take a look at the piston. See what's going on in there. I'll take the exhaust off. I got the exhaust off. Let's get down on the head bolts. This one seems to be in the frame's in the way right here to get to that one. So I'm going to find a different size socket. Thank you.
this should work.
I have a little mini extension. So there's your top head off. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, you guys want to see this? I'll show you exactly why. No fire. Check that out. This thing is toasted. Get it all ready, find a shop or something to either hone it out, bore it out, give me a piston, or I'm gonna order a kit online and we'll see what I can find. If I can find one. Okay, there's that. Rubber mallet. So we'll lightly tap it with my giant sledgehammer. Get it to break loose. There we go. Starting to come. Don't really want to pry anywhere where I'm going to break a fin. It's almost there though. Okay, finally got it to pop up. There's a little screwdriver on this side. Screwdriver on this side, and just kind of lightly prying on it. Seems like it's out. Thank you. cylinder out. Keep all the debris from falling down in my lower end over here. But as you can see, lower end spins free, nice. No play. Piston's got some. Piston's got some play in it though. This thing's worn down. Oh, this thing is pretty gnarly. Well, since I ordered a piston kit and everything, I might as well clean this thing up while it's all apart. So, let me start getting all the cobwebs and everything off. Just to get the cylinder head down to the machine shop and get it bored out and get this thing together. Well, I'm headed to the machine shop right now. We're gonna drop the piston off with the cylinder. Guy says it'll be done Monday, latest Tuesday. Kinda sucks. I was hoping to get it back sooner, but I'll live. I just dropped off my cylinder head and my piston. Old man seems like he can get the job done. He's a funny old guy. I would totally record him talking shit to me like he does, but I don't want to piss the old guy off. So, might get him on camera after he's done with my parts, but not before. Alrighty, so we wait for the call next week. Go pick up my fresh cylinder and my piston and get the bike back together. Alright, so apparently my phone was acting up. I guess I got the call this morning for my cylinder head and being done. So he just called me back. He's about to close right now, so I'm gonna race over there right now. Pick up the cylinder head. It's a little late in the day right now. I'll probably wait until tomorrow morning to start the going back together process, but we'll get it done now. Looking good, got the piston and my cylinder right there. Gonna head home. I might just go clean up the garage a little bit and wait till it cools off and just throw this thing together tonight and hopefully have it running before morning. Block all cleaned up, got my gasket on there. We're gonna start by, I already lubed it up and got one ring on. You're gonna lube the cylinder up inside here with assembly lube. Then you're gonna hit the piston on the skirts and get the wrist pin all nice and lubed up when you put it in there. And remember, when you're putting your rings on, you got these little pins right here. That's where your openings go. Okay, so I gotta get the other ring on right now. Got my top head, cylinder, everything right here all laid out. Try to keep it organized, it's a lot easier. So I'm gonna finish getting the rings on the piston, get the piston on the crank, and then start dropping the head on there and all that. Here we go. And when you get the rings on, after you get them on, you want to lube up the face of the rings. be very careful when you're putting the rings on. You don't want to bend them or force them on. You want to try to keep them true, because that's not good for the rings. So try to just work your way around very nicely. Make sure you're on your pin. This ring feels a little funky, but it is on the pin. Well, maybe that's why. Okay. I think I put the rings in the wrong spot. I think the other ring goes up top. Okay, let's get the top ring on. There we go, that fits much better. This is where you got your gaps. See how you got the locking pin? Right there, and right there. That keeps your ring from spinning around and catching one of your ports on the cylinder. So you want to make sure you put them on like that. Otherwise you'll have a catastrophic engine problem when the ring pops in one of those ports. Okay, so now we're going to take the assembly lube. And you're going to go around the face of the rings. Just on the face of the rings, get some lube. Make sure they're nice and lubed up. Inside the cylinder right now with some assembly lube. Just rub it around in there. Careful on these freshly machined heads, are really sharp. Already got my thumb once. Forget about your wrist pin clips, so make sure you put these in the right. Make sure they're all the way in when you put them in there, because that's a big problem is wrist pin pops out, scars the side of the cylinder, and gets stuck in between the piston and the cylinder wall. And just pull your crank up. Work the wrist pin right through. It should just push right in like that, nice and smoothly. No dinging needed. Getting this one out was hard. It's probably been in there since forever, so I had to bang on it. These wrist pin cuts are just little pieces of wire shaped like a C. They sit right in a groove right here inside the piston. You'll see the wrist pin when it pops in. You can all barely see it sticking out, so you'll know it pops in and sinks in there. Okay, that's on there. Double check, make sure your rings are still on there. And there's little dowels in there before you drop the cylinder head on. Okay. Next step, cylinder head. And as long as you're all nice and flat down here, nice and flat right here, you won't need no gasket cylinder or nothing. It should just go together nice and smoothly. Let me just lube it up one more time because I had my hands all over it. Make sure the skirt's got lubrication on it. Piston. And the rings. Check another time. Can't double check too many times to make sure everything's on there correctly, because once you kick this thing over, you will know. You don't want to scar that brand new cylinder up kicking it over. What you can do in this is just kind of squeeze the rings, get them to go up in there. And then issue here with this hole. Check. Make a tool to do this, but I'm kind of broke, so I don't buy all those fancy tools. One ring's trying to bite me, it's a little tight. Get it on right now though. Bit of a struggle getting that one ring on there. Got to get them closed perfectly so it doesn't catch the side of the head from the piston up. Gotta get the piston up and person out, wipe off all that little extra grease right on top right there. That way it doesn't mess with the spark or anything. I'm gonna snug this down right here. Four head bolts. They're a 14 millimeter. Thank you. Let's start by getting them all just barely snug. And then evenly work your way around. Try to tighten them down evenly. Help prevent any gasket leaks. I'd work my way around, evenly tightening them all down. They're all snug right now, so just go around, tighten them little by little. Try to get it straight. Should be good, tight like that. I'm gonna work on top head next. Two strokes are pretty simple. Probably should have cleaned it. I'll clean it up after it's all together though. I'm gonna do the same thing on this. Get them all just barely snug. Work your way around. So just tighten one side and then the other side tighten. Kind of like a car tire. So get it tightened down all evenly. I'm using a little tiny extension with a short socket. Kind of helps me get my ratchet to fit in between the frame and the work I need done. Otherwise you'll have a little bit of trouble fitting your wrench in there. There's that part. You might as well wipe it down right here and get some brake clean on there and try to get that dirt off. Get it better in a little bit. That's good enough for right now. Just try to just get this thing back together, huh? Okay. I'm gonna throw my spark plug in. It's 13/16 spark plug. Careful, make sure you get the plug in straight. Mine tried to go a little crooked right now. So never force it, always double check. Make sure you're going in correctly. Last thing you want to do is strip out a top head, putting in your plug wrong. The whole head's back together. Now you're gonna work on your revalves. Get your gasket and your revalves inside there, and then your intake on top of that. So, we're gonna start with the revalves. Really good. Stick them in. Ooh, almost forgot one of the gaskets. You can just set the gasket on there. Stick it up there with the gasket on the revalves. And you're gonna take this gasket, the next gasket, it goes that way, on the revalves like that. About 6 volts for the 10 millimeter. Honestly, this probably would have been easier to put the intake and revolves in with the head off the bike, but I've been so excited to get that piston in there since I ordered it. That's kind of where I wanted to start. Okay. is just little 10 millimeters. You don't want to break them off in there. So take your time with these ones. Don't over torque them. Okay, here we go. Pop the carb on. You know what, while we're right here, I haven't even looked in the bowl of this carburetor yet before I pop it on there. I'm gonna take the bowl off real quick, double check, make sure we're not slimed up in there. Just being stubborn. Looks like someone stripped that one out in the day. It's been stripped. So you know what, since it's stripped out, save that job for later. Let's hope this carb is in tune and runs and no jets are clogged. Could just check real quick. Floats are functioning, it's clear right there. So, you know, let's test my luck because this bolt's stripped out. I'm not going to try to mess with it too much right now. Kind of want to see if this thing will just fire. At least I'll butt it on something, some kind of noise. I think I put it on there upside down. Rookie mistake. Flip it around real quick. Getting too excited. Try not to do what I did, put it on upside down, pay attention. Obviously I wasn't paying attention. Just a little setback. Yeah, well, obviously it's upside down because on this there's a cutout for the top of the carb. I totally overlooked it. Should have noticed that before I ever got the carb on there that far, but whatever. It's been a while since I worked on one of these. for at least 10 years since I had one of these bikes. Not too much of a setback. Now, where were we? I'll put this carb in. See if this thing will fire. I'm going to hope that the carb's good. This bike, according to the previous owner, was running within the last few months, and they just blew it up last time they took it out. So it takes me obnoxious. Sometimes you gotta help him out. All the way up in his home. Get your clamps around. Let's see if my gas can have any gas in it. Nope. No gas in that can. I don't want to use the gas that's in the tank. Could be old. But. So I'll have to go get gas in a little bit. Until then, let's get this exhaust back on there. My springs are somewhere around here, but for now I'm just gonna just bolt it up. Things are laying around somewhere. I'm gonna find those in a little bit. One thing I forgot to get prepared for, putting the exhaust back on. But different size bolts, whoever had this bike before obviously worked on something right here. That's on there. Let's get the baffle on there, spark arrestor, whatever you want to call it. Looks like I'm missing a bolt for this and the spring that goes right here as well. So I'll have to find a, probably just go get a spring kit if I can't find the ones I have laying around. But for now, let's get a spring kit. too big. Back, shorter bolt. So they're good enough. I'll get one bolt down here. I'm missing spring right here. Two springs on the front are missing. Put it on there though. No gas in here either. Drain this tank. I could just siphon it out once it's on the bike, but so we're gonna get this tank on there, mounted up, hook the hoses up, and then we're running the gas station. I'm gonna get a fresh gallon of gas, mix it up, and see if this thing will start. Rubbers that hold the fenders down good, but alright, so I gotta drain the tank, go get a gallon of gas. So I'll be right back in a second with the tank drained and the new gallon of gas. We'll see if it fires up. So I got the oil draining right now. I'm gonna head and check the oil. It smells like gas. Definitely don't want to hurt the bike with some gas smelling oil. Got it draining into a jug right now. Made a little mess on the floor. It's not a big deal. If you don't know, take out this little oil check right here, and then you fill it up till it leaks out at you. While that's doing that, I'm gonna find my mixing cup. Somewhere around here. Where did I set it? too misplaced my mixing cup, so I guess we'll eyeball it, Rich. Stop dripping out down there, so we can put a plug back in. We got oil coming out right there to almost the whole quart. Let me mix up my gas. Should be good. Be a little rich, but make sure our gas line's hooked up. Mix is about roughly 20 to 1. Just eyeballed it, so it could be a little over, a little less. But we'll see if it fouls the plug right out the gate or not. Started. So my baby's asleep, so we're gonna have to roll it out to the street. Try to test fire it real quick. 1 second. Move a whole bunch of stuff around real quick. We'll roll it out to the front. Let it idle for a little bit. Let it get warmed up. We get some gas. But there you have it. We go top in. I don't want to go too hard giving it gas right now. I want to let it warm up. Let it get settled. But don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Till next time, have a good one.